I gotta wait for it. Oh. Yeah, I don't normally draw vertically, so this is gonna be a little strange. Hello. Today we will be learning how to draw this. I hope you can see it, because I think it looks pretty good. I hope you got your pencils, because we're gonna do this thing, like Bob Ross. That's gonna be good. Hello, Todd.
Hello, you're doing great.
I don't normally do tutorials, so I hope I do well on this. Okay, so we're gonna be doing this, but bigger, obviously. So you wanna first get your thing adjusted so that it's not wibbling and wobbling all around the place. Yeah, that looks about right. Okay, I'm gonna draw a big old circle, not too big, because you still need room to add the neck and the hair and stuff. Okay. So, next thing you need to do, take your titanium flat, no, I'm just kidding, and make a line, maybe down here, and make it in the middle, make it really straight, because it's going to be a front-facing drawing. Make it, that looks proper, like, can you see it? Maybe they can see it very well. Okay. Then, left hand, this is kind of odd. So you want to make another kind of vertical line there. Not too wide. Not too wide. That looks about right. Weird. Okay. And you kind of want to just connect the dots from the middle line to the bottom. Leave a little space for the chin, of course. Connect the dots. This guy's face is a little bit longer than my drawing. What I'm going to do is we're going to cut the circle off a little bit, make it a bit smaller. Adjust it. Because this is our world. We can do whatever we want in our world. Yeah. Okay. So, okay. So then, in this little, so hooray! You've made your face. You're done. No, I'm just kidding. About in the perpendicular crossroads. I don't know how to describe it. You just draw these two straight lines. They can be straight. They can be kind of bent like that for the nostrils. And just, this is what I do. You don't have to do this, but I just kind of add this little nose shape thing. And then, somewhere up here, I don't normally use guidelines. I normally just kind of use my intuition. So somewhere up here, make eyebrows. Eyebrows are good at indicating expression. These, make them kind of long, longer than you think they're going to be. Because they need to go over the eye, extend past it. This one, this eye is going to be wide open. Make kind of that shape, and then make that shape like upside down. That does not look anything like my drawing. Oh, it's hard to copy things, so I guess that's it. And this one, the eye is going to be closed a little bit. Oh my goodness. Not looked at all. What I have done. I'm going to make that a bit smaller. And I like to draw a line for the eyelid. So make one like that. And since this eye is a little bit more closed, the line's going to be closer to the eye. Still draw this thing. That doesn't look anything like what I drew. Oh my goodness. Oh, I dropped my pencil. Sorry if I'm bad at this. I'm gonna redo the nose a little bit higher. Make this guy squint a little bit. And normally what I like to do is I like to draw two little connecty dots. Connect the dots for the smile. And this guy, he's gonna be looking off to his left. So we're gonna draw two little circles. One eye is just way wider than the other one. That's great. That's great. Doing this on live TV, that's wonderful. Okay. Hi, Dad. How's it going? Dad's watching this right now. So I'm saying hello. Oh, my goodness. So if you get any part of this wrong, that's okay, because some people have facial deformities, and that's a thing. So if he doesn't look good, then that's all right, because some people look like that. And like from the middle of the eye to the top of the eye, and kind of bottom, or you can make like a teacup shape almost. Like his head is a mug, and you want to drink it. And make this curvy line, and then do the same on the other side. Teacup shape. I don't even know if anybody's doing this or if I'm just doing this and just to do it. I hope people are doing this. Then you want to make the hairline. Don't make it too close to the eyebrows because people have foreheads. I know. It's crazy. I need it. And then, like, right about here is where I normally would do the hair, like, the hair part situation. I don't know why I always do it there, but do lines like this on the eyebrows, because I don't know why, but it's something about the nose. His body's going to be kind of facing this way, and so his neck has to be kind of slant. Don't forget to make it curvy. Necks aren't straight. They're just not. One shoulder's gonna be like that. And his other shoulder's gonna be like that. I don't know what he's doing. Maybe he's doing a cool skateboard move. Who knows? It's very quiet in here. I wish there was some music. I feel uncomfortable. Not uncomfortable, just alone. Oh my goodness! I don't know if I'd call that music, Kevin. And we're going to make a line for the shirt. Make it a bit above the shoulders because it's not part of his skin. It's a shirt. I got a second line for the seam. The seam. Boy, it's looking pretty good so far. It's looking cool. I like him. What'd you say he looked like, Mom? You gave him a name.
Michael.
Mom thinks he looks like a Michael. Of course, he's bald right now, but erase the top of his head. Okay. My favorite thing to draw is hair. Just make like a bunch of triangles. They don't have to be good triangles. My favorite thing about drawing hair is that you can be really loose and flowy with it as long as you know the rules. The rules are, a lot of the time, you gotta keep it the same length throughout. And it's not, like, it's not gravity resistant. There's always some gravity in there. It's not bad. I know. Just kind of add a bunch of weird triangles. You can make them bigger if you want them to have fuller hair. It's like a ring around the head, like a circle. And I always like to add these little things because some people, you know, like hair on their neck. I'd say that looks pretty good. I can outline it too. Todd, should I outline it or do we not have time for that? Yeah. Outlining is pretty fun. I don't normally do it vertically. I normally draw my stuff flat on the table. I'm trying to do good with that. So if you have a pen, you can line it. And be confident, you know? It's not scary. It is scary, actually. It's very scary, but that's just how it is. This is your world. He's got a shirt on. You can see it. Or hopefully my hand's not in the way all the time. Do you think they can see it, Tom? Okay. Did you know? Okay, if it's a little off, I'm gonna erase the pencil, you know. I hope I'm not wasting y'all's time. Not what I want to do. I'm just gonna talk about random stuff, I guess. Whenever I see Caden and Daylan and Julian together, I always call them the squad. 'Cause you always see them together, you know. If you need to find one, you just have to look for one of the others, and boom, there they are. So that's really handy. Hair doesn't have to be; it can be clean, smooth lines if you want it to be. Around, whatever you want to do. This is your world. They keep laughing in the background because they know I'm funny. You guys wanna send it to me? You can. I'm on Instagram. A lot of you follow me, so send it to me. I'll review it. I was thinking that the prize could be like a half second hug. A half second hug from yours truly. Not too long though, because then Mom would get mad at me. I had so many ideas for what to talk about earlier. Now I can't think of any. That's a shame. A lot harder to draw on my tablet because my tablet at home doesn't have a screen, it's connected to the computer, and so that's a lot harder because I can't see what I'm doing. I have to be constantly looking up while my hand's down here, so that's a bit difficult. And if you want to, you can make your eyebrows just one straight line, that's fine. I figured why not. Now you can do the hair. And the hair. Oh, I didn't even see the little. I like to do these little thingies on his neck. I just think they're really fun to do. After the hair, you just draw a bunch of V's. Add extra stuff into the hair. I hope y'all's look good. If they don't, and you think they don't look good, then don't be discouraged, because I saw a post online where this person was like, "Oh, my cake's not better than that other person's cake," but then another person was like, "Oh my goodness, two cakes." So it's still art, and people will still enjoy it, even if your cake isn't as good as another person's. And now, what we're gonna do, I hope this looks good. Ugh. I'm gonna fill in the eyes. If you have a white gel pen, you can just do the whole eye and then draw you. But I didn't bring mine, so I'm just gonna draw that. And then fill in the top part. It's pretty fun to do. Oh, I completely forgot to draw another circle. For the little glint, little gleam of hope in his eyes. Right now he doesn't have any hope. He is a shell of a human being. And I'm sorry for him. I feel sorry. But that's just the way it's gotta be sometimes. Todd gave me a Coca-Cola. Little did he know I had one before we came here. Now I got a free Coca-Cola. So yeah, I think that's pretty good. No, I'm not done yet. We still gotta erase. This is my sushi eraser. I really like it because it erases very well. So once you're done with that, you just go ham on it. You know, be aggressive. Maybe you hate him. Maybe he looks like your worst enemy, and you're like, oh my gosh, I hate you. Get out of here. I'm trying to fill space. I'm sorry. Oh, I forgot. Oh my goodness. Okay. So if you want, you can add like a lower something below his eyes if you want. Oh, now he just looks tired. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this segment of Rock and that you had a good time drawing.